Greetings of the day. I am Lakshman Jajodia, Assistant Professor, Department of Advanced Management Studies, GES College of Commerce, Vardhan. In this video of HR specialization of subject Compensation and Benefits Management, we will discuss about wage fixation. In the earlier video of second unit, we have discussed about what is wage, what are the types of wages, and what are the methods of pricing or calculating the wages. In this lecture, we will discuss about what is wage fixation, what are the methods, or which are the institutes which are responsible for wage fixation in India. When we talk about wage fixation, it is not a century-old phenomenon in India particularly. In pre-independence era, there was not any kind of structured and proper machinery for wage fixation and settlement of wage dispute among workers and the employers. In post-independent era, it was found out that industrial relations became a major issue, as there was continuously rising industrial dispute in which it was found that it was mostly over the wages, and this has resulted in the loss of industrial peace, hampering the production activity and economic activities as well. That is why in the post-independence era, it was realized that by government of India that for the purpose of having industrial peace, it is necessary to have a structure format for wage fixation and settlement of dispute. Keeping this in mind, a tripartite conference was formed, which consists of representatives from the employers, from the labor and the government as well. This tripartite committee or conference is used for the purpose of determining the wage fixation. The major concern or the major problem was at the time of after the independence was off, there was not any proper machinery from the government end which can help us in reducing the industrial dispute. That is why in 1948, with industrial policy resolution which was formulated by government of India, it has mentioned two items which are related with the wages. First one was statutory fixation of minimum wage, and second one was promotion of the fair wages. Both the terms we have discussed in the earlier lecture. Minimum wage, which should be given by any employer to his employee irrespective of the ability to pay of the organization. Fair wage, which is necessary for the substantial livelihood of the employee, which is more than minimum wage. This was all about wage fixation, which is an important criteria for any employee from the end of employment. Now we will discuss about which are the various institutes which are responsible for wage fixation and how wage fixation is done in India. The very first criteria we can say that is the legislation, which are a group of laws which govern the wage fixation in India. Again, it is worth to be mentioned that apart from payment of wages Act 1936, earlier there were in pre-independence period, there were no laws governing for wage fixation. In 1948, government has formulated minimum wages act. These both acts were constituted for wage fixation in India. We have discussed what is wage or minimum wage according to the Minimum Wage Act 1948. It has been mentioned in the act that after every 3 years, there should be revision in the wages considering the ability of the worker, inflation rate and workers' productivity. For addressing this problem, there were certain guidelines which were issued timely by the government so that the functioning of the acts like Minimum Wage Act, Payment of Wages Act should be functional, and after particular time there were amendments according to the changing environment in the industry and circumstances. Second thing which they have taken into consideration, or second institute which is responsible for wage fixation, are the wage boards. It is another method by which we can fix the wages of the workers or laborers. The Royal Committee has recommended, first of all, that there should be wage boards in India, and the first wage board was appointed in the year 1957 for particularly cotton textile industry. Later on, various wage boards came for the industry like sugar, cement, tea, coffee, rubber, plantations, iron and steel industry. At that time, when the wage board came into existence, there was quite problem regarding to the minimum wages and payment of wages. That is why wage board came in force, so that the irregularities can be eliminated from the industry with regard to the payment of wages. Considering the constitution of wage board, it is a tripartite in character, which has three representatives from employee, that is labor or workers, and at last it has an independent chairman also, which is responsible for the decisions and the proceedings of the wage board. We can divide wage board, or there can be two types of wage board. First is statutory wage board. It is a body which is set up by the law or with legal authority, so that minimum wages and other such standards of employment can be legally enforceable in the particular industry according to the decisions and the recommendations made by the wage board. This is an legally bound thing, which a legally bound body which has to deliver the decisions, and it is need to be followed by the industry. Second type can be the tripartite wage board. It is a non-statutory body, and it is voluntarily negotiating body set up by the discussions with the employer, employee and the government for the purpose of regulating wages, working hours and the environment, as well as the prevailing condition in which a labor works. This body is an independent body which is formed to resolve the disputes among the laborers as well as the management or the employers. What can be the possible objectives of the wage board? Is number one, to have the more durable results, so that the problem of industrial dispute as well as unrest can be reduced for the longer tenure. Second one was the improved climate in the industrial relation, as we have discussed in the first criteria, introduction of wage fixation. There was in post independence mostly there were disputes in the industry and employees regarding to the wages. By the formulation of the wage board, these disputes can be reduced to minimum. Next thing is, it helps in promote the interest of both customers as well as the community. On an aggregate, wage board is not only for the welfare of the workers, it is for the regulation of the industry. Next thing is, it helps us in safeguarding the interest of the employee. It has been seen in the immediate post-independence era that there was quite loss of the interest of the workers in the particular industry like cotton, textile, sugar, tea, coffee, rubber, iron and steel, etc. And for that purpose, wage board came into existence, so that they could safeguard the interest of these workers, so that they could have substance of their livelihood as their wage. Next thing is, another thing was their objective which was taken by wage board was to suggest a system of payment by results. It doesn't aim that one employee or worker should receive X amount due to which is right. It says that everyone should receive the amount according to his or her ability on which they show their results. And last one, it helps in governing the principles with regard to bonus, which should be given to the workers by various industries, so that there should be support to social economic policy of the government also. We know that every employee after working for an year expects that his company or her company should give him or her a bonus, and for that purpose wage board gives certain principles and formulates certain policies which helps in determining this bonus issue. Secondly, it helps us in getting the objectives of government, that is social as well as economic policy related objectives, so that there would be overall development of the employees as well as the society and community as well. That is why wage boards were established in that period. Next thing would be the pay commissions, which will be discussed in the coming videos. Until then, stay tuned. Thank you.